Welcome to Quixotic Academy. In this video, we will discuss pre-release material for O-level Computer Science Paper 2, October-November. Let's have a look at the pre-release material. There is an online computer shop that sells customized personal computers. Every computer sold includes a basic set of components costing $200. It means that every basic computer a customer buys is of $200. That is the minimum price at the shop. Next, additional items can be added from the table. So this table contains all the additional items that a customer can buy with his customized computer. These items include case, RAM, hard disk drive, solid state drive, second hard disk drive, optical drive, and operating system. We will look at it again later. As well as the basic set of components, every computer must include one case, one RAM, and one main hard disk drive from the table. It means this is the starting price, $200. Then one from the case and one item from the RAM and one item from the main hard disk drive has to be selected to buy a computer. So these three things are required. Then a computer is supplied with or without an operating system. So the operating system is not required, but each one of these is important. It is required. What we have to do is write and test a program or programs for the online computer shop. Your program or programs must include appropriate prompts for the entry of data. Data must be validated on entry. This is very important point. Do not skip it in any case. Error messages and other output need to be set out clearly and understandably, which means all the categories, codes, description, and prices need to be displayed properly in a proper readable manner. Next is all arrays, variables, constants, and other identifiers must have meaningful names. This is also a required step in every program you do. Okay, moving on to task one. Before moving on to task one, let's see how many variables we can identify from here. One is the basic set of cost, which is $200, and we have to use some variable which will display the category. We have to use some variable which will display the item code, the description, and the price. This is something we can tell at one look that we need these variables. Next, they said that every computer must include one case, one RAM, and one main hard disk drive. It means we have to use some variable to select these. Okay, so moving on to task one, setting up the system and ordering the main items. Write a program to use arrays to store the item code, description, and price. Allow a customer to choose one case, one RAM, and one main hard disk drive. So first of all, we will use arrays. They have told us to use arrays, so we have to use the arrays here. We will keep an array for all the categories. We will keep one array for all the codes. We will keep one array for all the descriptions and one for the price. Also, the data type has to be mentioned, so it is obvious that these three are of string data type because this contains some text, some alphabet, some numeric values. Since prices are floating point numbers, so this array will be of type float. Let's start writing the pseudo. We have already assessed these variables from the text written in the task. So we have basic price containing $200. In float, we have item category and array that contains all the categories provided in the table in the same sequence here. Then we have item codes and we have item descriptions, same sequence. Then we have item prices. Prices are with decimal points, so this is a float array. We have already talked about it. Next task is to allow a customer to choose one case, one RAM, and one main hard disk drive. It means we have to display the cases first. The customer will see there are two cases available, A1 and A2. We'll see their description, their prices, then choose anyone from them. And we will add the chosen item in a list because we have to calculate the price in the end. Next, the customer will see all the RAMs available and choose one. Next, the customer will see main hard disk drives available and then choose one. So here we have to display these prices descriptions properly in an understandable manner. First, a customer will choose a case. So we are using a loop here because we know that there are only two cases, and we use for loop when we want to iterate for a predefined range. So our range is from 0 to 1. Since you are already programming in high level languages, you know that arrays index start from 0, so there is no problem using the 0 in pseudocode as well. So what we are saying is, from 0 to 1, from this index to this index, print the following. So we are saying press press 0 for item category is case, because at the 0th index there is case. We are using this case value as an index to all of these arrays. So the item category is case, the item code is A1, the item description is compact, the item price is 75. In the next iteration, we are saying press 1 for case, A2, tower, 150. This way, we are displaying all the items to the customer in an understandable, readable, and friendly manner, so you can choose properly. Next, there is a variable called item category location. So I have used this variable to locate the specific items from this list. Okay, so item category location is 0 for the cases, because first case arrives at the 0th index. If I want to use the RAM values, I will say item category location is 0, 1, 2, because RAMs are starting from the second index. Then if I want to use main hard disk drives, I will say item category location is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You will see the impact of this variable later. It is very useful. After saying all the description and prices, the customer will choose one item from this list. So we have already said that press 0 for first, and we have already set the press 1 for this. So after taking the input, we will verify that the user has to press 0 or 1. So here we are performing the validation. If while choose an item is not 0 or choose an item is not 1, we will print again press 0 or 1 and again take the input, again validate the input, and this will go on until the correct input has been passed. The task 1 also requires us to store and output the chosen items and the price of computer. So it means whichever case has been selected has to be displayed in the end. We have declared a new array, chosen item list. In this array, we will keep all the chosen selected items to display in the end. We will append. The append means we are adding a new item in the array. Previously the array was empty. We have chosen one item, so we want to add that in the list, in the array. So we are going to append the item category location plus chosen item. I have already told you we are going to use item category location to locate the position of the item in these arrays. Since cases are at the index 0, so we are going to say that for example, the user has entered 0 here, he want to buy the first case. So at that time, the chosen item list will have 0, because item category location is 0 and the input is also 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. It means that the case A1, whose description is compact, whose price is 75, has been chosen by the customer. Similarly, if the user selects second case, if the user enters 2, second case means the user has to press 1. If the user presses 1, we will say that store 0 plus 1 in this list. It means store case A2 tower and 150 price as a chosen item. Next, we will display all the RAMs available. Before that, we have to change the value in the variable item category location, because now we want to display the RAMs here. So we will say the we will set the item category location to 012. So the index of RAM is 2. So here we have set it 2. Then we will print a proper statement saying please select one RAM from the following. Now we have also increased the iterations here. We want to iterate from 0 to 2 because there are 3 RAMs available. While we were selecting the case, only 2 cases were available, so we used 0 to 1. Now there are 3 RAMs, so our for loop will iterate 3 times. So we are saying from 0 to 2, it means 0, 1 and 2. So we will again print the, we will say press 0 for RAM B1 8GB with a price of 79, press 1 for the RAM B2 with 16GB and the price of 149, and press 2 for the RAM B3 32GB and the price of 299. After we have displayed everything, we will again take the input in the variable chosen item. We don't have to keep separate variables for all the chosen items because we are already keeping a list. We are already keeping this list. So we will again use the variable chosen item. The customer will enter 0, 1 or 2. We will verify and validate. If 0, 1 or 2 is not pressed, we will ask for input again. And we will add the chosen item and the chosen item list again. You see now item category location is 2. If the user presses 0, he wants to buy RAM number 1, so he will press 0. We will add in the list 0 plus 2. As you can see, 0 plus 2 leads us here. That's why we have used an item category location variable. The name is meaningful. We want to locate it in the list, and this will help us keep the chosen item list tidy and organized. We will write the same pseudo code to take input of main hard disk drive. There are 3 hard disk drives are available, so again we have displayed a loop from 0 to 2. We have changed the item category location to 5 now because AGDs are placed starts from the index 5. We are again taking the input, validating the input and storing in the chosen item list. Next task is to calculate the price of computer using the cost of chosen items and the basic set of components stored, and output the chosen items and the price of the computer. So now we know that the customer has chosen one case, one RAM and one AGD. We have to calculate the price and displays the chosen item. We have final price equal to basic price at the beginning because basic price of $200 is preset, predefined. Next we will display all the chosen items and calculate their prices as well. We have initialized a loop. Counter variable is used in the loop. This will run from 0 to the length of chosen item list. So length is a keyword to calculate the length of something, and it is available in almost all high level languages. So we will locate the item using the value in chosen item list. So for example, if the case 0 was selected, chosen item list will have 0 here. If the case 0 was selected, chosen item list will have 0, and the item category 0, the item code 0th index, the item description 0th index and the item prices 0th index has been accessed to display the related values. Then we will add the price in the final price. Thank you for watching. We will continue the discussion in next couple of videos. If you have any questions, please do comment. I will try to answer all of them.